Elliot with Yo Elliot. You've got strength questions, I've got your answer.
Yo Elliot.
Today we've got a question from Javelin Thrower.
Yo Elliot, it's Austin. I got a question for you. I'm an overhead athlete. I'm a javelin thrower in college, and I'm just wondering what you do to fix a winging scapula and to keep my upper back and throwing shoulders strong and ready for competition. All right, thanks.
All right, so here's the situation. You're asking about winging of the scapula for overhead athletes or athletes who perform any type of throwing motion. Very common because you're developing through your pattern overload because of your sport. Throwing, either if it's a baseball or if it's a javelin, you're developing a pattern overload where the muscles in the front part of your shoulder become very short and tight because you're using it to accelerate the implement that you're throwing, and at the same time you're stretching out the muscles that set your scapula in place. So if that could, hopefully you can visualize, but as you throw this way, you're lengthening those muscles, strengthening and shortening these muscles. There's a name for both types of muscles. That these become very tonic, which means overdeveloped. The nervous system recruits these muscles, especially when you have pattern overload issues like you're experiencing right now. The nervous system recognizes that path as having least resistance, and everything you do outside of your sport, you're going to experience basically your muscles are going to be recruited there faster than the phasic muscles on the other side. So what happens to the muscles on the other side is that the nervous system just doesn't even recognize it as a viable path to traverse. It just doesn't even know how to recruit those muscles. So I can show you all types of cool things to do, but what you're really gonna need to be able to do is, first of all, draw some nervous activity. Get your nervous system to even recognize that there are muscles back there. Because what ends up happening is when I start teaching people how to adduct their scapula so that you don't have that winging any longer, and you tell me if you experience this, I tell them to draw their shoulder blades together and they do this. Like, they just can't do it. They end up using another tonic set of muscles that usually end up being overdeveloped for throwing athletes, which is your upper trapezius. So your idea of scapular adduction probably looks like this, which is what you're doing anyway when you're throwing. So my suggestion would be to first learn how to isolate the adductors. And that's going to take a lot of conscious behavior. You're really going to have to pay very close attention to how you perform certain exercises. So let me start you out really quickly with a floor-based movement that you could use. Throw this into your routine after you train and do it right after stretching the overdeveloped tonic muscles. So the muscles that you're going to stretch. So it's a stretch and strengthen thing. If you know, people talk a lot about muscle imbalance, but really what muscle, in order to create balance, there are certain muscles that need to be stretched and lengthened, and the nervous activity that's shot into it needs to be lessened. You need to pull out some of the nervous activity in that tonic muscle. The best way to do that is to stretch it. That's why we stretch correctively. We don't just choose random stretches. For you, you're going to have to stretch the pec minor, which is the best way to do that is find a corner of a wall, split the corner of your wall with your feet like this, elbow to the side of the pinky against the wall, bang, you lean in and you turn away. So you're going to feel a big stretch in your pec minor and your whole chest and the front of your shoulder. Another one that's probably going to be short on you is your bicep. What you're going to want to do is you're going to stretch your biceps out like this. Take your palm and your elbow, extend your elbow up, turn your palm down, put it against the wall. You feel a stretch all throughout your hands into your bicep. And then, like I mentioned earlier, your upper trapezius, which is your neck, basically you're just going to lean this way. What I like to do is have people grab a bench, and you're going to sit on the bench, hold on to this side here, and lean away. And as you lean away, it's like you're anchoring your shoulder, and then you're going to put a little pressure on the side of your head. You're going to feel a huge stretch through your neck, down into your entire arm probably. So what you've just done is, you've not only stretched out, but you've taken the nervous activity out of the neural drive, out of those muscles. Now they're not going to be recruited as quickly when you do the following corrective exercises. So the very first one that I would suggest is something called the prone cobra. You're going to lay down on the floor, face down, prone. That's why it's called the prone cobra. Squeeze your butt. I'm squeezing my cheeks right now. Take your thumbs, turn them out. External rotation of the upper arm is coupled with thoracic extension. So just by rotating your arms out like this, you're going to extend your thoracic spine and you're going to drop your shoulder blades down and together. And then you're just going to hold this with your chin tucked in, looking at the floor, just going to hold this position. As you're holding that, you've got, like I said, you've got to make a conscious effort to keep your shoulders down away from your ears. Drive them down, pick your chest up, and think about your, if you can imagine what your shoulder blades look like, they look like two big arrows. Point them down to your tailbone. So as you're doing this, you're pointing down at your tailbone. You can do this movement. You could just totally be wasting your time if you don't make a conscious effort to draw your scapula down and together. So those are two things. Start there. Once you want to start integrating, like I said, you've got to isolate and then integrate. Once you want to start integrating those into movements, start with deadlifts, like I've showed you in the past. If you watch some of my older videos, with the palms up, basically you take a heavy barbell and you force thoracic extension and you just hold that barbell there. What that's doing is it's stretching out the pec might, upper trapezius, the biceps, and in order to keep your shoulders back or your shoulder blades pointing at your tailbone, you're gonna have to really force thoracic extension. So that would be the next progression from the prone cobras to the deadlift holds, and then going into actual deadlifts with a supinated grip. Okay, that's it. If you start using these things and you correct that scapula winging that you're having, or if you just are experiencing less shoulder pain from the information that I told you here just now, send me a comment down below, let me know. The rest of you dudes, keep sending me your video questions. I'm here to answer it for you. Talk to you next time. Yo, Elliot.